taking a step away from Gallivant and talking about your role in Supernatural, because there's a massive Supernatural fan base here in Australia, very passionate about the show.
As they should
and be. You played the character of Kane, and even though you were actually only in a handful of episodes, I felt that you brought a very strong intensity and gravitas to the role. Was there a particular mindset that you channeled, or say a character who inspired you for that performance?
Not really. The thing that helped on that show is I was friends with a lot of those actors already. I knew Robbie Thompson, who created the character. I'd known him for years from other shows. John Badham directed the first episode I did, I think, three or four times before. It's like, so I was already very comfortable going in. You know, that first episode I just worked with Jensen and Mark, I've been on for 20 years. Jensen I had never met before, but felt madly in love with him immediately. He and Jared both are just, everybody on that show, they're some of my favorite people in the world. That's why I love traveling the world in this crazy carnival circuit called conventions that we do. Robbie and I did sit down though before we started shooting, just because I wanted to get his input on where he saw the guy going. And there were two jumping off points, and they were just simply jumping off points. One was the movie Unforgiven, one of the greatest westerns ever made, and the other was a graphic novel, Old Man Logan, which tells the story down the road, and both of them are sort of that reluctant, you know, the guy reluctantly pulled back into whatever the life he had shunned. And that was just the starting off point. Because by the end of, you know, that first episode, he's in Executioner's Song. Oh my, is he in.
Now, was there any particular, I guess, aspect, because it was only, you know, it was a handful of episodes with that character, and was there any particular aspects of that character that you would have liked to explore that you didn't get the opportunity to?
Not really, because, I mean, we did two episodes. And I just loved it. I had such a great time on the show, shooting the show. I loved the character. And immediately, you know, I think I was on hiatus from Psych the first time I did it. So when Psych ended, I actually called Robbie and was like, I'm available, put me back in. Coach, and the schedule didn't work out, and then I got Gallivant. And when I came, I think I did the second episode while I was on hiatus from Gallivant. Yeah, because I'd grown my hair out. I again emailed him and said, I'm off work for 6 months. And he texted me back a minute later and said, I'll get back to you. And 2 minutes later, he's like, all right, we got a slot. So I would, again, because of my relationship, I was going to go. If I may, if we're going to do this again, here is what I would like to see. And the part, so I was able to ask him if we could explore these parts. And to me, I wanted to see Kane the Badass. I wanted to see who that guy was in that brief flashback from the first episode where he's in full bloodlust mode. And he sat down with Robert. And he pitched me the episode that he had in mind, and it just checked every box. I couldn't win.
So you felt very satisfied.
Oh, that's great. Yeah. So good. I don't know where we would go again. I don't know what we would do. We've seen him as civilian. We've seen him full bloodlust, unless they did origin stuff. It was all flashback.
Yeah.
I just dyed my beard at one.
Now, you mentioned that you have done quite a few conventions. You've actually been out here a couple of times.
Jeez,
Is there any particular, I guess, city that you haven't seen in Australia that you'd like to
visit? Yeah, I've never really even seen Australia. The fact of the matter is, as I remind my wife, as I'm about to get on a plane and leaving her with two, you know, teenage daughters and the hell that involves all that life, it's like, I'm not going on a pleasure trip, baby. This is work. My schedule tomorrow is, you know, it's up at 7. I'm working until 10 o'clock at night. I think I'll have got Monday off and I got a buddy in town, so he and I'll get together. I'm gonna be on a plane.
Yeah. Not much opportunity to sightsee.
No, and the fact of the matter is it's no fun for my wife anyway, so
fair enough.
It's now, true, honey, I mean it.
So you have a couple of projects coming up. Anything you can tell us about?
I do. I've got I did an indie film last summer called Carter in June, which is about to hit the festival circuit, which is madness. I play it's a caper film. I guess that's how you would describe it. It's I play a character named Spencer Rabbit, who's a gay southern psychopathic strip club owning gangster, which was rich. It was very rich.
Sounds like a very complex.
Oh my god, it was so fun. It was so great. We shot that with some great people in New Orleans. I just finished another little movie called Bottle of Honey, which really saw the days of the light of day. I'm about to go to Pittsburgh to work with my old friends John and Kat from Gallagher on a show called Downward Dog, which is a lovely little series that ABC is making based on a beautiful web series called Downward Dog. Going to Germany to sing at a music festival with Jason Manns and Rob Benedict and Logan Swann and some of the Supernatural music guys, and I'm busy.